Well, sir, he'd give Orley some, and off they went to Orley's house, a-chawin', a-blowin', and a-poppin'. Directly they got there, Dingley gave a chunk to an old hen. She chewed it and started to cluck. Well, I gone as she clucked a little bubble and thought it was an egg and set on it, and it took four hens and a rooster to get her loose from the chicken coop door, and she left all her tail feathers a-hangin' there. Well, sir, Dingle, he started to blow another bubble. Got bigger and bigger, and pretty soon it was big as a milk pail. And it kept a-growing and got big as a barrel. And then it got big as a water tank. Then it got as big as a barn. And all of a sudden, Dingle sneezed. Ha-choo! And it sneezed itself right inside the bubble, and just then it started a-rolling. Help! He says, get me out, Orley! Well, by this time, the bubble was a-rolling fast down the road, and Orley, he's a-trying to catch it. There's an old man a-coming along, and Orley, he says, stop the bubble! The old man, he says, why, sure, and he stuck out his hand, but I gone as he stuck right through the bubble and rolled down the road with it, a-yelling,
help! Help!
Just
help,
then, an old woman help, come along, and Orley help, says, stop the help, bubble! Help, well, sir, help, she stuck out her help, hand, and sure enough, she help, stuck to it, too, help, and went a-rolling down the road, a-yelling,
help, help, help!
The next thing, a little baby come out to see what was happening, and it got picked up, too. Then that there bubble hit a rock and bounced up and sucked two birds off in a telephone wire. Then it rolled along and picked up an old cow. Then it bounced down on the river and picked up a big boat and just kept a-rolling along. Well, sir, about this time, Orley seen the wind dance along through the treetops, and he says, Mr. Wind, please blow this bubble back before it picks up the whole world. Mr. Wind, he says, why, sure, and he started a-blowing. Well, sir, he blowed that bubble right back where it come from. It crossed the river and the boat dropped off. Then the cow dropped off. Then the birds unwound. Then it set the baby down right by its house. Then the old woman dropped off. And then the old man. And finally it rolled right into Orley's yard and smashed into the barn and busted. Well, sir, it took 3 days and a quarter turpentine to scrape it off the dingle, and when they's through, he says,
well, duh, I sure had bubble trouble, by gum.
That's all. Night was real dark. Orley's little dog, he started in to bark. Well, Orley rushed out and says, what's going on? But when he got there, the little dog was gone. He followed him across the fields and down the woody lane. He crossed the creek and climbed the fence, and then here come the rain. He saw the lightning flash, and he heard the thunder pound. And all of a sudden, he saw his little hound. He was sitting real still, and he let out a growl. Then his hair stood on end, and he started in to howl. Oh! Well, Orley looked up, and he saw an old shack. The doors is all open, and the windows all cracked. Orley's eyes got big, and he looked all around, and all of a sudden, he heard a strange sound. He stood stock still, and he says, I'm scared. And then there came a sound that was twice as weird. Orley grabbed up his dog and he held him tight, and still another sound came out of the night. Orley let out a yell, tried to run away, but before he took a step, he heard a funny voice say,
oh, please don't go, we won't hurt you at all. Come on in the house and pay us a call.
Well, Orley just didn't know what to do, but he spoke right up and says, who are you?
Well, listen, says the voice, Orley, don't be upset, cause I'm just the ghost of an old clarinet. Now, this feller here is the ghost of a flute. Just listen real close and he'll give you a toot. This other little feller can never get low. He's a little bitty ghost of a silver piccolo. We used to play on the radio, but our keys wore out and we just wouldn't blow. We turned into ghosts when they threw us away. Now an old haunted house is all the place we can play.
Orley says, Mr. Ghost, that surely sounds sweet. If I could only hear some more, it'd really be a treat.
Yes, indeed, says the ghost. Here's a good one for you.
music stopped.
And the woods was still. That's all, said the ghost. We gotta say goodbye. Ghosts can't play when the moon rides high. Goodbye.
Well, Orly took his dog, went home and went to bed. But he'd often go back when the moon was dead. So, if you hear a funny voice, when you're way out all alone, don't you be scared.
It's probably just a spook of an old trombone.
Sunset, little Orly, he's a-going back to the house after helping with the milking, and just as he passed the tool shed, he heard a funny kind of a scary sound.
Howdy-do, Orly.
Well, sir, he looked up, and he seen a big old bull fiddler hanging way up in the rafters. Hey, he says, what you doing there? Well, the old bull fiddle, he says,
I used to belong to your great-grandpappy. I've been a-hanging here for 49 years, and I'm so lonesome.
Well, Orly, he clomb up and got the old fiddle down, and the old bull, he felt so happy he just had to do a little dance on his one leg. Well, sir, Orly picked him up and took him in the house and leaned him in the corner and went to bed. But along about midnight, the old fiddler got so happy at being there that he just had to do another little dance. Well, sir, Orly's folks waked up and said, what's that noise? And Orly, he told them, and they were going to put the old fiddle right back in the shed. But he promised to be quiet as a mouse, blowing bubbles in a feather bed, so they let him stay. Well, the next day, Orly, he went off to school. But about noon, the old fiddle, he got lonesome, so he went a-hopping off to find Orly. Well, he found Orly's school, and he stood under the window, and he called and he called.
Orly, Orly.
Well, Orly's teacher got mad, so his Orly had to come out and send him home. Orly, he was mad, too, and he told the old bass that if he didn't be good, he'd give him to the woodpeckers. Well, the next evening, the old bass, he was walking around the barnyard, and he seen Orly's paw. So he says,
howdy-doody-doo, howdy-doody-doo to you.
Well, sir, it scared Orly's paw, and he dropped his watch in the hog pen and the hogs at it, and they wound up a-hanging the poor old bull fiddle back in the shed. Well, one day Orly, he was down by the creek a-playing, and all of a sudden he fell in and started to wash downstream. He let out a yell,
help!
And his ma and pa come a-running, but before they got there, here come the old fiddle. Well, sir, he dove in the creek and went a-putting off towards Orly. Well, he got to Orly. Orly climbed on, and they came back to shore, safe and sound. And Orly's folks just hugged that old fiddle, and Orly's paw got him some new strings and glued up his top and oiled his pegs, and he got to sleep in Orly's room. And every night, just before Orly goes to sleep, the old bull fiddle winks at him, and he says,
that's all.
Named Orly, and he wanted to get himself a cricket. Well, he looked out in the big green meadow and over by the red barn, and pretty soon he found a little old black cricket. Well, happens he passed the blacksmith shop, and the old smith, he heard the cricket a-chirping. So he says,
howdy, Orly. I sure would be proud to have that cricket.
Well, Orly gave it to him, but he's a little lonesome for it, too, so he puckers up, and he says,
I went all day to get myself a cricket. I got myself a cricket, and I give it to you, but you give me nothing at all.
Well, now, the old smith, he felt pretty mean, so he gave Orly a nice hoe. dig a well with his bare fingers. And when he seen the hole, the old man, he says,
"My poor old fingers is about to give out. I sure could use that there hole."
Well, Orley, he give it to him, and then he says, "I went and told A.T. to get myself a cricket, and I got myself a cricket, and I give it to the smithy. Give me a hoe, and I give it to you, but you give me nothing at all." Well, now, the old man, he hit water about this time, so as he gave Orley a bucket full, and Orley taken out for home. Well, he yipered along a small piece, and he seen a poor old tree a-creaking and a-groaning in the wind. And when the tree seen the water, he says,
"I sure wish I had some water to grease up my poor old aching, creaking joints."
Well, Orley, he poured the water on the tree, and then he says, "I went all day to get myself a cricket, I got myself a cricket, and I give it to the smithy. Give me a hoe, and I give it to the old man. He give me water, and I give it to you, but you give me nothing at all." Well, the old tree, he felt kind of bad, so as he reached up and picked a big old green katydid off in his trunk and gave it to Orley, and Orley hit for home again. Pretty soon, he passed a big old bully frog a-setting by a puddle, and the old bully frog, he says,
"Howdy, Orley. Nice katydid. Let me take a look at him."
Well, Orley, he stepped up and zip-zap, the old frog grabs the katydid and swallers him. Well, Orley's good and mad now, and he says,
"I went to old A.T., get myself a cricket, and got myself a cricket, and I give it to the smithy. Give me a hoe, and I give it to the old man. He give me water, and I give it to the queen. He give me katydid, and you add him up, and you give me nothing at all."
Well, the old frog looks at him, and he says,
"Uh-huh, and what's more, I ain't gonna give you nothing." And he dives, ker-flop, into the puddle.
Well, that just goes to show you that you can't expect to get every time you give. And if you do expect it, sooner or later, you're going to lose your katydid. Orley did.